Welcome to the Friday Chat with Kate McMillan as we look ahead to TAB Everest, the world's richest race on turf, over $1,200, the $15 million feature. Katie, what are we going to do with this field? It seems to be a little open to me.
Oh, it does. Every year since it started, it's just shaped up to be just the race of the year, hasn't it? You can make a case for so many horses and third time lucky. I'm feeling Nature's Trip this year might have it in the bag, but it is going to be an awesome event and I can't wait to get out there on Saturday.
So if you had to pick your top three, who would they be aside from Nature's Trip, of course?
Yeah, so Nature's Trip on top for me. And then I've got Geetra. So he's drawn barrier one. He's going to get a nice run. He handles the conditions if it happens to be on the wetter side. I'm working on a soft track at the moment, but I know that Geetra will appreciate those conditions, and just drawing one, he's just going to get a really nice run behind the speed. And then I'll put the Inferno in for third. I think he's a really good horse, this. He's lightly raced. I thought he was very unlucky not to win the Moya last start. And before that, he relished the conditions. I think it was a soft five or soft six at Mooney Valley to win the McEwen first up. So I just think that this horse can run a little bit of a race.
Well, let's talk about your top three win bets on the card. And you've gone for In the Star Mile, Soldier of Love.
I have. I forget that this horse went round at Rosehill last start. The track was just a little bit too firm for him. He does like to get his toe into the ground. So I think that he'll get that. He loves Randwick. That's another big positive for him. And before that, he went round last start at Rosehill. He wasn't too far away from them in the Cameron. So Joyous, she won the Coonji, now running in the Caulfield Cup on Saturday. He wasn't too far away from her. So I reckon that'd be the right form lines for a race like this for Soldier of Love.
And in race four, you like Decent Rain?
I do. The Melbourne filly, she's coming out of a group three where she was a little bit unlucky, where she just got back, had to wait for a run, and really powered home. Love the way that she hit the line. And a lot of these horses are coming out of maiden winning their maidens and then are going into this race. So I'm going with the horse that's been running around in the group threes and barrier three. She's going to get the run of the race. So Decent Rain for me there, SV.
Now you're going for Handle the Truth in the Kosciuszko.
Yeah, well, this horse has been chasing home the top sprinters. And I just think that this is a little bit of a drop in grade. I know it's a Kosciuszko. He won it 2 years ago, and then he was brave when he ran fourth in it last year behind It's Me. So I just reckon this will be a nice drop in grade. He's clearly the best horse in the field for me, and I think Handle the Truth definitely wins the Kosciuszko.
And in the Heineken 3 handicap, we've gone the Cummings horse. Wow.
I have. Now, this horse probably doesn't want it any worse than soft. Definitely handles the soft, but I don't think he'll probably get through a heavy. He's only lightly raced for a six-year-old, having his 10th start. He's won four of those. And, look, I just think that he maps well for an each-way bet. So horse 10, hopefully James can get Suave home in the last.
And your big horse to follow, you've gone the Grey.
I have. The horse to follow, it has to be Classique Legend in the Everest, because he's fascinating, right? He hasn't raced in nearly a year. He raced over in Hong Kong, of course, and then he's come back. And just what a training performance will it be from Les Bridge to win the Everest first up on sort of a soft track over the 1200. I just can't wait to see him back. We all know how good he is, but to win the Everest first up will be extraordinary. So can't wait to see him, and I'll be watching him very closely.
Well, it's fair to say whatever he does is going to be market improvement out of him. And, of course, K-Mac, our good friend there, Karen, is going for his fourth win in the race. Unbelievable, isn't it?
Oh, it's crazy, isn't it? He just doesn't matter whether it's a sprint race or a long-distance race. Karen is a top-class jockey, and, yeah, I'm sure he'll be wrapped to get aboard the big grey and the big dance on Saturday.
And can you give us a sneaky insight as to what your partner James McDonald is, how he's feeling aboard Nature's Trip as we head into Saturday?
Very confident, SP. He's really wrapped with Nature's Trip and how he's performed in his two runs in. He just said he's had a faultless preparation. Third up is usually when you see the horse run at his best. So he's third up in the Everest, and I think he's very, very happy that he drew that outside barrier so he can sort of ride the horse and not so much the race and keep him nice and happy. And hopefully the rain keeps continuing to come, because he absolutely will relish the conditions, and I can't wait to see him win. I think he deserves a race like the Everest on his CV. He's been a pretty good sprinter in Australia.
That's absolutely right. All right, well, Katie, we look forward to catching up with you on Channel 7 live and free. And, of course, for anybody that wants to tune in from home or abroad, you can do that by Sky Racing platforms. Good luck.